Hello everybody, my name is Jaimin Patel. I am an assistant professor of plant pathology at Lincoln University in Jefferson City. I'm going to be talking about lettuce drop, which is caused by two fungal species, Sclerotinia sclerosiorum and Sclerotinia minor. These two fungi also cause diseases on tomato, coriander, celery, cucumber, melon, squash, legume, and pepper. During this talk, I will be providing information about lettuce drop symptoms, how this disease spreads, and what can you do to protect the lettuce from Sclerotinia species. Lettuce drop disease symptoms can be identified by looking for wilting symptoms on outermost layer of the leaves, which will indicate infection to the ground. Once pathogen has infected the plant, the crown will have brown lesion or spots which will turn into soft tissues or watery decay, followed by snowy white fungal growth which will cause the entire plant to wilt or drop. And this disease symptoms is referred to as lettuce drop. You can see the photograph on the right uppermost corner which indicates lettuce drop symptoms. As disease advances, you can see in the second photograph on your right side, the sclerotia will produce, which is black in color, and eventually there are actually more sclerotia will produce either on leaves or crown area. There is a photograph on bottom right corner along with the ruler, so you can imagine how big or small this sclerotia could be. The sclerotia of Sclerotinia minor and Sclerotinia sclerosiorum infects the lettuce crop in different manner. Most of the time, sclerotia of Sclerotinia minor infects the crop directly, whereas Sclerotinia sclerosiorum produces mushroom-like structure called apothecium, as it can be seen on the photograph. This mushroom-like structure or apothecia produces lots of ascospores, which can be dispersed by wind currents, and these spores land on the plant surfaces, which will eventually cause a new infection. Now let's talk about management of lettuce drop. Before you plant lettuce, always think about how can you avoid lettuce drop, because this disease is difficult to manage. First thing, you avoid the wet soil and keep the bed or soil surface dry. Also, plant lettuce on raised bed, which can help reducing the wet soil. You can also think about any strategies that can reduce the leaf wetness period as well as leaf wetness in your farming system, because more leaf wetness period will provide pathogen a chance to infect the leaf tissue. You can also scout for diseases in your farming system, which will allow you to identify initiation of any new infection, collect those infected plant at early stage, put them in a bag, and you can destroy it. So other healthy plants have a chance to thrive and you can harvest healthy lettuce. You should also consider a variety that avoids the leaves touching the ground, because several times pathogen is on the soil surfaces and they can invade the leaf tissue through the ground. There are also a few fungicides available for control of lettuce drop. These fungicides should be applied before you see any infection to be effective and to be able to manage the lettuce drop. Make sure you read the fungicide label every time before you apply these fungicides on your lettuce crop. If you have any further questions, feel free to contact me at my email patelj@lincolnu.edu. This email address can be also seen on your screen. Thank you very much for listening.